Presentation is about understanding the hybrid vehicles. Okay, I believe my earphone, like my microphone, is working well. I'm trying my hard. Okay. If anyone had any problem with the mic, I'm sorry. This is the far best I can do. Okay. So please excuse me that. So understanding the hybrid vehicles. So basically, we are here to learn about hybrid vehicles. So what is a hybrid electric vehicle, or HEV? That's a short form, hybrid electric vehicle. So any vehicle or a hybrid electric vehicle uses multiple energy source for propulsion, or for the driving of the vehicle, it uses multiple energies. It is visible from the picture itself. So it uses an IC engine, means an engine that converts heat energy into mechanical energy as a primary source. Primary source. This is the first way or the best way this can be propelled. Okay. But also it had a battery pack. I'm saying battery pack, not a battery. Okay. They have a battery pack that converts or that store electrical energy, and a motor that converts this electrical energy into mechanical energy. Okay. So what this motor actually doing in this vehicle? So you have an engine and an electric motor and a big battery. So everything is actually clubbed to do one thing. So the motor is actually playing an assistant role, like your junior instructor or something like that. It assists the engine to drive the vehicle, and it depends on the battery pack and the size of the motor. Okay. So which this part I already told you in the last class. So this is just like a refresher slide. So basically, why we need a hybrid vehicle? Again, this is also a familiarization class. So IC engines or our engines are not very efficient at lower RPM. I'm saying lower RPMs or low vehicle speeds. And if you look at the diagram, or if you look at the torque values, they produce the torque at and around 2000 RPMs. Okay, which is you have to rev the engine up to 2000 RPM to just get moving. At least 1500 RPM means 1500 RPM. You have to raise the engine RPM to get some torque from the engine, just to get moving. Okay. But this condition is actually very toxic in nature, because you are using fuel, and ultimately at this condition, the fuel may or may not burn completely. There may be more oxygen, and ultimately it will produce more carbon monoxide, nitrous oxides, CO, carbon monoxide, NOx, nitrous oxides, sulfur dioxides, etc. So all this actually pollute the air. Delhi peoples will know better, I believe. Automobiles are one of the major source of air pollution. But on the other hand, electric motor are very efficient in producing high torque, very high torque at very low RPMs. Okay. They produce very high torque at very low RPM. So that during the conditions where IC engines are failing, we can use this motor, and such a combination will actually increase our fuel efficiency, means mileage, and also will reduce the emissions. Okay. So where the IC engines cannot perform, electric vehicles performs much better. Or where engine does not have efficiency, electric motors performs far, far better. Okay. So literally, from here onwards, I will explain maybe somewhat in other languages too. Okay, so what are the types? It's very simple. There are three types of hybrid vehicles, especially micro, mild, and full hybrids. So as you can see, the full hybrids are again divided into three: the series hybrids, the parallel hybrids, and the series parallel hybrids. Now again, full hybrids are also divided according like conventional hybrids and plug-in type hybrids. Okay, so just remember this. I will explain each and every classification in this presentation. Okay, so you will have a doubt why full hybrids have this much classification while micro and mild hybrids don't have, like micro and mild hybrids don't have any classification. Okay, full hybrids have around 5 classifications. So why it is? So that's answer. Only full hybrids has the ability to completely run on electricity. Okay, so they are flexible. Okay, micro and mild hybrids are not flexible in operation because they cannot and they will not run purely on electricity. They are running on their engine. Okay, so yahan dekhe to aap logon ko ek cheez aa jayega, hybrid vehicle ko teen classification hai, micro, mild and full, aur full hybrids ko 5 classification hai. वो सीरीज हाइब्रिड, पैरेलल हाइब्रिड, सीरीज पैरेलल हाइब्रिड, वो उसकी ड्राइव ट्रेन के तहत आते हैं. और जब आपकी चार्जिंग की बात आती है, वो फुल हाइब्रिड दो तरह की जो है, कन्वेंशनल एंड प्लग इन टाइप. तो क्यों फुल हाइब्रिड? फुल हाइब्रिड ही इलेक्ट्रिसिटी में, बस इलेक्ट्रिसिटी में रन कर सकते हैं. बाकी दो, माइक्रो हाइब्रिड और माइल्ड हाइब्रिड, वो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी में, पूरे के पूरे इलेक्ट्रिसिटी में रन नहीं कर सकता. इसलिए फुल हाइब्रिड के लिए इतना क्लासिफिकेशन है और माइक्रो माइल्ड हाइब्रिड में कोई क्लासिफिकेशन नहीं है. लेकिन वो दोनों ही हमारे देश पे पूरे के पूरा फैल चुका है. सो व्हाट इज ए माइक्रो हाइब्रिड? वी एक्चुअली हर्ड दिस वर्ड इन महिंद्रा. सो व्हाट्स अ माइक्रो हाइब्रिड? दिस इज नॉट ए रियल हाइब्रिड इन द नेमसेक. दिस इज ए नेमसेक. Okay, it's not a real hybrid. It's just a start-stop system. Okay, it's just start and stop the engine. So it switch off the engine when you are idling for more than 10 seconds. Like if you are in a traffic block, you are going nowhere, your traffic light is red, and if you are putting the gear in the neutral position and waiting there while your engine is idling, it will switch off the engine for saving the fuel. It's just save the fuel. Okay, it does not do anything else. It just save the fuel. Okay, so this thing actually will be much more familiar to you. The Scorpio. Scorpio is actually Scorpio, not even Scorpio. Majority of the Mahindra's vehicles are actually micro hybrids. They have this start stop system. And if you are thinking that it is only for the four wheelers, no, we had the same system in the Hero motorcycles. Splendor iSmart is again a start stop system. You can switch on the system and switch off the system. Like micro hybrid is completely switchable. You can switch on, you can switch off. There is a switch to activate this and deactivate this system. Okay, so if the engine is off, how we can restart the vehicle? Like if the green light, like I said, if you are in a traffic block and your engine is off, this system, the micro hybrid system, actually switched off your engine, then how you start it? So for that, if you have a manual transmission, you just have to press the clutch pedal and the vehicle, the engine will automatically start. You don't have to turn the key. Okay, you don't have to turn your ignition key. you just press the clutch pedal and the vehicle will automatically start. And if you have an automatic transmission, then you press the accelerator pedal and the vehicle will automatically start, because automatic transmissions don't have any clutch. Okay, provided, as I told you, in a manual transmission or automatic transmission, the gear should be in neutral. Okay, so what the micro hybrid do is, it saves the precious fuel. While it was like, if we are sitting in a traffic block, we will not turn the engine off. So the fuel is being lost. The fuel has been burning. So what this is doing is, it just saves that fuel wasting due to the idling. Okay. So what's inside? Iske andar kya hai? Micro hybrid ke. So first of all, as I told you, this doesn't have any, it's not a real hybrid. So it doesn't have a electric motor. It's like, it don't have a big electric motor. As I told you about the hybrid, I said there is a battery pack, there is an electric motor. No, in a micro hybrid, you don't have a big electric motor. Okay. It will not assist the engine. It will not drive the vehicle. Okay, micro hybrid will not do what you just heard about a hybrid. Okay, but what it do have is something called an ISG, integrated starter generator. It, you can say, it's a reversible alternator. Reversible alternator. So what is a reversible alternator? What alternator do is, it get drive from engine and it charge the battery. Right, alternator charges the battery and alternator is driven by the engine. So reverse means, yes, your alternator receives current. Instead of charging the battery, it receives current from the battery and start the engine. It actually rotates the crankshaft. Instead of going in the opposite way, in the normal way, it comes back. It takes the current from the battery and restart the engine using the same belt drive. Okay. But not all the vehicle may have this ISG. So some very cheap vehicle will not use this kind of ISG. They instead go through the normal starter motor. Okay. So here, one thing you have to understand, it doesn't have a separate electric motor. It doesn't have a battery pack. It works with the same 12-volt battery you have in your car. Okay. There is no battery pack. There is no separate electric motor. What you have is something called ISG, integrated starter generator. So what is an integrated starter generator? So as I told you, it's a reversible alternator. So it looks just like an alternator, but bigger. Ye badhiya hai. Alternator ki, ab jab aap alternator ke saath se compare karo, ye normal alternator se kuch badhiya hai. Because it has to act as a motor also. Okay. The current comes from the battery to the stator coil of the alternator and it works as a starter motor. So you don't need another starter motor, literally. Okay, your vehicle don't need a starter motor. This thing, the alternator itself, do the job. So it will be like this. You have the starter motor or the alternator, one unit do both jobs. So ISG do the job of starter motor and ISG do the job of alternator too. So it drives the, or it starts the engine via the belt drive. Okay. In some vehicles, this belt driven ISG won't be there. Instead, it will be placed in the bell housing or on the flywheel, you can say. Okay. It will be between engine and the transmission. Okay. So what it all about, what this micro hybrid is all about. So it just give you a higher mileage. अगर आपको 10 मिलते हैं, 10 किलोमीटर पर लीटर मिलते हैं, ये आपको 2 किलोमीटर एक्स्ट्रा दूंगा, 20%। ओके, दिस इज व्हाट ए माइक्रो हाइब्रिड इज, बट इट्स वेरी सिग्निफिकेंट स्टेप। ओके, दिस इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप इन हाइब्रिडाइजेशन। ओके, नाउ कम्स द माइल्ड हाइब्रिड। दिस माय फ्रेंड्स, इट्स राइट नाउ we are using in the Suzuki cars. Okay. Now this is the starting point where you have a powerful electric motor and you have an additional battery storage, not a battery pack, battery storage. Keep it in mind, not battery pack, a battery storage I am saying. Okay. The motor is now starting the engine, and also it can help the engine while the load is very high. If you are climbing a hill, agar aap ek mountain chadh kar rahe hai ya hard accelerate de rahe hai, to ye motor aapke engine ki madad kar sakte hai. Okay, it cannot drive the vehicle though. Okay, alone without engine it cannot do anything, it just help the engine, assist the engine. Okay, so if your vehicle is big and you need a lot of power, the ISG will be sit, it again use the same ISG principle, but it sits behind the engine and in front of the transmission. Or you can have a very big alternator, reversible alternator, you can use the same. Volkswagen and many of the Benz also, Benz vehicles also uses the same principle. Okay. Now it uses a separate battery. As you can see, this is not the 12 volt battery. It's a 48 volt battery pack, battery, not battery pack, battery, a single battery. Okay, it doesn't have a battery pack. Okay, so here same. Okay, now here is your ISG, the motor is situated here and it charges this battery. Again, if needed, this battery will provide current to the alternator or the ISG and it will assist the engine. Same here, this is the ISG, integrated starter generator. It charges the high volt battery, not high volt, 48 volt battery, normally 48 volt is the battery size. And when needed, the battery will supply the current back to this alternator so that it will help the engine. Okay, now the amount of assistance or the help and the duration of help depends on the size of ISG and the capacity of the battery. So bigger the battery, more time you will get the help. Bigger the motor, bigger the help. Okay, ye aapki ye wala aapki मारुति और बेंस और ऐसे कुछ गाड़ियों पे यूज कर रहे हैं. ओके, ഇതാണ് നമ്മളുടെ പ്രധാനപ്പെട്ട മാരുതിയിൽ ഉപയോഗിക്കുന്ന മൈൽഡ് ഹൈബ്രിഡ് സിസ്റ്റം. എർട്ടിഗ ആണെങ്കിലും സിയാസ് ആണെങ്കിലും എല്ലാതും. ഓക്കെ, നൗ ഇതാണ് പുറമേയുള്ള വണ്ടികളിൽ, വലിയ വലിയ വണ്ടികളിലെല്ലാം ഉപയോഗിക്കുന്ന സിസ്റ്റം. കാരണം വലിയ ആറ് സിലിണ്ടർ എഞ്ചിൻ ഒക്കെ ആണെങ്കിൽ ഇത് ഉപയോഗിക്കേണ്ടി വരും. സോ ഹൗ ഇറ്റ് ലുക്സ് ലൈക്ക്, ഹൗ ദ സിസ്റ്റം റിയലി വർക്ക്സ്. Small engines will be using an ISG and big engines will be using a larger ISG near the flywheel. Okay, so this is one of the smaller ISGs. This is what the Maruti is using. As I told you, there will be a separate battery. This is the ISG unit or integrated starter generator. Okay, and this is the control system. Okay, here you have the engine pulley. Okay, now if you have a bigger engine, very big engine, and you have an automatic transmission, this will be the ISG. You can see this is the electric motor and this is the automatic transmission. Okay, so it will be sitting just behind the engine. Okay, it can also regenerate the system. Means if we are not accelerating, if we are taking our foot off the accelerator or we are braking, this thing can work as a generator and recharge the battery. That's what we called a regenerative braking. Normally, right now, the system is actually working on 48 volt. Majority, 99% of new cars with a mild hybrid system uses a 48 volt system. Okay. Again, it can also function as a micro hybrid. So let's see what is the layout. So this is the layout of a 48 volt micro hybrid. Okay, as you can see, it's pretty simple. You have the engine here. You have the electric motor. DC to AC to DC converter, because this is a AC machine. AC current produce karne wali machine hai alternator. So you need AC current inverter and 8 electric motor, ISG. Okay. Now you have your battery here. Okay. Number 3. Okay. Number 2. That's a battery. And that's a battery controller. Okay. So literally, this design has been used by the Benz, by the Volkswagen, by the Maruti. You can name the person, you can name the company. It actually uses this kind of mild hybrid system nowadays. Okay. Now the 48 volt battery will be sitting or will be placed under the rear seat. Okay. Even you take the Maruti, it will be actually in some Marutis it has been placed under the co-driver seat. Okay. Co-driver seat ke niche kuch time ke liye Maruti aisa dete hai, co-driver seat ke niche de 48 volt ki battery. Lekin majority of time this 48 volt battery will be sitting below or under the rear seats. So whatever you're saying in this electric supercharger is actually an optional. Okay. Some may have, some may not have. It's not an integral part. It's not an important cheese. Okay. So this battery can also, this 48 volt battery can also charge the 12 volt battery, our normal battery, via a DC to DC converter. As you can see here, a DC to DC converter. Okay. Now comes the most important hybrid. Okay. This is the most important hybrid, the full hybrid. The full hybrid has the ability to drive completely on electricity. Ye pure ke pura electricity pe drive kar sakte hai. Okay. Engine ki koi zarurat nahi. Pure ke pura electricity pe drive kar sakte hai. That's why it is highly flexible. Okay. So the electric motor is powerful and the battery pack. Right now, it's not battery, it is battery pack. Okay. The battery pack is very big for driving the vehicle. It can drive the vehicle itself. This is one from the Lexus. You can see the hybrid battery. You can see the engine, electric motor on both the front and rear wheels. Okay. And there is an ECU also. So how this thing works? Okay. Right now, the electric motor power is increased so that the engine power can be decreased. Your engine is now less powerful so that the motor has been given importance. Aapki gaadi ki engine ki power kam kar diya hai kyunki aapki motor ki power bada di hai. Okay. To ye average vehicle ki baat kar rahe hai main. Supercars ki nahi. Main supercar ke ek example dunga. So the motor is highly powerful and it can assist the engine at any time it wants. So engine can be less powerful. And again, right now, the battery pack is high voltage and it can be hazardous. So like the battery pack, already high capacity. Seriaya protective equipment illade adu nannakkano allengil adinte puruthu paniyana poi kinnal marnasam vara sambhavikkam hazardous aanu. आपकी बैटरी पैक राइट नाउ आपके लिए बैटरी नहीं बैटरी पैक मिल रही है। ये बैटरी पैक हाई वोल्टेज का है और अगर आपके पास जरा भी प्रोटेक्टिव इक्विपमेंट नहीं है तो आप मरने की भी संभावना है। सो व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ फुल हाइब्रिड्स? एज आई टोल्ड यू देयर सेवरल टाइप्स। सो इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द ड्राइव ट्रेन अरेंजमेंट। यू हैव थ्री डिफरेंट कॉन्फिगरेशन एज आई एक्सप्लेन इन द बेसिक स्लाइड लाइक द टाइप्स ऑफ हाइब्रिड स्लाइड्स। यू हैव द कॉन्फिगरेशन ए कॉन्फिगरेशन बी एंड कॉन्फिगरेशन सी। दिस इज द कॉन्फिगरेशन ए ए बी सी। ओके सो आई विल एक्सप्लेन। सो दिस इज द पैरेलल कॉन्फिगरेशन। ओके एज यू कैन सी दिस इज द इंजिन दिस इज द मोटर एंड इन दिस अरेंजमेंट द मोटर ड्राइव्स द व्हीकल एट लोअर स्पीड मीन्स अप टू 30 किलोमीटर आवर पर आवर अप टू 30 किलोमीटर दिस मोटर विल बी ड्राइविंग द व्हीकल। ओके एंड द इंजिन विल बी ड्राइविंग द vehicle at high speeds. You have a transmission. You may not need a transmission in this vehicle. Okay. So നിങ്ങളുടെ വണ്ടിയുടെ ആദ്യത്തെ അറേഞ്ച്മെന്റ് എങ്ങനെ വെച്ചാൽ പാരലൽ അറേഞ്ച്മെന്റ്. ഈ സാധനത്തിനകത്ത് നിങ്ങളുടെ മോട്ടറാണ് ഒരു ലോ സ്പീഡ് വരെ നിങ്ങളുടെ വണ്ടീനെ ഓടിക്കുക. അതിനുശേഷം എഞ്ചിൻ ആയിരിക്കും നിങ്ങളുടെ വണ്ടി ഡ്രൈവ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. ഓക്കെ ഈ ഗാഡിക്ക് ഡ്രൈവിംഗ് ഇലക്ട്രിക് മോട്ടർ മേ ഹോ ജായേഗ. ഓക്കെ ഇലക്ട്രിക് മോട്ടർ ആപ്കി ഗാഡി ഡ്രൈവ് കരേഗി at low speeds pe or engine drive karengi high speeds pe. okay ye arrangement dono ke liye ek hi hai. agar aapki motor drive karna chahte hai to wo kar sakte hai aur engine drive karna chahte hai to wo bhi kar sakte hai. second arrangement is called series hybrid where electric motor only drives the wheels. engine cannot drive the wheels. it can only recharge the battery. so this is the configuration B. okay where you can see engine is not connected with the wheels. okay only motor is connected with the wheels. okay so what engine do is engine use the generator and charge the battery and the motor actually using the battery current and drives the vehicle. And the next one and the last one is the it's something called series parallel hybrid, which means it can do these two guys. It can actually works like these two. So it can work as a series hybrid where engine runs the generator, charge the battery and drives the motor, or it can drive the vehicle. So you have something in between them. I will explain that when it comes. So what's a series hybrid? Okay, here IC engine is the primary source. There is no doubt about it. Primary power source is the IC engine. Okay, but it's not driving any wheels. Okay, the electric motor is responsible for driving the wheels. Aapki electric motor aapki drive ki ek ki aasray hai, you can say. Okay. നിങ്ങൾക്ക് വേറെ വഴി ഇലക്ട്രിക് മോട്ടോർ മാത്രമാണ് നിങ്ങളുടെ വണ്ടീനെ ഓടിക്കുക. ഓക്കെ സോ ഗിയർ ബോക്സ് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന സാധനം അവിടെ ഇല്ല. ദർ ഇസ് നോ ഗിയർ ബോക്സ്. ഓക്കെ ബിക്കോസ് ഇലക്ട്രിക് മോട്ടോർ ഹി ഗാഡിക്കോ ചലാത്ത ഹൈ. ഓക്കെ ഏസ ലഗേഗ ആപ്കി സീരീസ് ഹൈബ്രിഡ് കി ലേ ഔട്ട്. ഓക്കെ എഞ്ചിൻ പെട്രോൾ എഞ്ചിൻ കെ ഡീസൽ എഞ്ചിൻ ബി ഹോ സക്തേ എഞ്ചിൻ ദർ ഇസ് എ ജനറേറ്റർ ആൻഡ് ദ ജനറേറ്റർ ചാർജസ് ജനറേറ്റർ പ്രൊഡ്യൂസിങ് എ സി കറണ്ട് സോ യു നീഡ് എൻ ഇൻവെർട്ടർ ആൻഡ് ചാർജസ് ദ ബാറ്ററി and the battery produces and the current in the battery is used by the motor to drive the wheels. Okay, so in the vehicle it will be looking something like this: engine, generator, the controller, the battery and the electric motor to wheels. Okay, so engine drives the alternator and it's big enough, the alternator is big enough to recharge the battery pack. Okay, the motor is actually taking the electricity from the battery to drive the vehicle. Okay, so what's the merit, why we need a series hybrid? agar aap mein series hybrid ki baat kar rahe ho to series गाड़ियों के पहले सीरीज कार्स की सीरीज हाइब्रिड कार्स के पहले ही हमारे पास इंडिया पे सीरीज हाइब्रिड व्हीकल दे हमारे डीजल लोकोमोटिव डीजल ट्रेन एक सीरीज हाइब्रिड ट्रेन है, सीरीज हाइब्रिड व्हीकल है। ऐसा ही ये जब मैं बोला था ऐसा ही ट्रेन पे काम हो रहे हैं। നമ്മുടെ ഡീസൽ ലോക്കോമോട്ടീവ് ഡീസൽ ട്രെയിൻ ഒരു സീരീസ് ഹൈബ്രിഡ് വണ്ടിയാണ്. നമ്മുടെ റോട്ടിൽ വണ്ടി വരുന്നതിന് റോട്ടിൽ നമ്മുടെ കാർ വരുന്നതിന് മുമ്പേ തന്നെ നമ്മുടെ നാട്ടിൽ ഉണ്ടായിട്ടുള്ള ആദ്യത്തെ സീരീസ് ഹൈബ്രിഡ് അതാണ്. കാരണം അവിടെ എൻജിൻ ഒരു വലിയ ആൾട്ടർനേറ്ററിനാണ് ഓടിക്കുന്നത്. അതിൽ നിന്ന് ചെറിയൊരു ബാറ്ററി ഉണ്ട്, ആ ചെറിയ ബാറ്ററി ബഫർ പോലെയാണ്. അവിടെ നിന്നാണ് ഇലക്ട്രിക് മോട്ടോറുകൾക്കാണ് പവർ കിട്ടുക, എൻജിൻ്റെ താഴെ വീലുകൾക്ക് ഇലക്ട്രിക് മോട്ടോർ വെച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട് ട്രെയിനിൽ, നമുക്കറിയാം അവിടേക്ക് പവർ കിട്ടും. അതുപോലെയാണ് ഇതും വർക്ക് ചെയ്യുക. സോ എന്താണ് ഇതിൻ്റെ മെറിറ്റ്സ്, വട്ട് ആർ ദ മെറിറ്റ്സ്? So engine is almost running on its peak efficiency. You are not accelerating or decelerating the engine. It is actually working in a perfectly high efficient condition. So you get maximum mileage. Okay. It works perfectly, almost in a constant RPM. Okay. So the electric motor provides good torque. When start from the starting onwards, it provides good torque. And the battery pack is always charged. This thing, this layout is from the Chevrolet Volt, V-O-L-T. Chevrolet Volt car was a series hybrid. Again, India had its series hybrid cars. Honda Civic Hybrid was the first series hybrid car in India. Honda Civic Hybrid. Okay. वो एक सीरीज हाइब्रिड कार दे, होंडा सिविक हाइब्रिड पहले सीरीज हाइब्रिड कार दे इंडिया पे. ओके ये तो एक शेवरले वोल्ट VOLT वोल्ट की डायग्राम है. ओके सो इट्स दिस इज द मेथड. यू हैव टैंक, यू हैव एन इंजन, द इंजन ड्राइव्स द जनरेटर, इट क्रिएट्स करंट एंड द करंट विल बी चार्जिंग द यूज्ड टू चार्ज द बैटरी एंड दैट battery is used to drive the motor and the motor will be driving the wheels. Okay, but the problems are the total energy efficiency is very low because you are converting the chemical energy of fuel into electrical energy. Okay, so in between that you are converting the chemical energy into heat energy. Heat energy, like in IC engine, you are converting the chemical energy into heat energy and then into mechanical energy and then into electrical energy, and that electrical energy is again converted into mechanical energy. So you have multiple energy conversion. Okay, the chemical energy is converted into ultimately mechanical energy after heat, mechanical, electrical, again mechanical. So you have a lot of energy loss. Again, another point is, if the battery or the motor, if the motor is damaged, done, you are not going anywhere. Okay, if the battery is done, you are not going anywhere because engine is not connected with the wheels. It is the motor that drives the wheels. Agar aapki motor kharab ho jaye, battery kharab ho jaye, to aapki gaadi waha rukegi kyunki engine gaadi ke wheel tak connect nahi kiya hai, bas motor hi ആപ്കി ഗാഡിക്കോ ചലാത്തിയെ. ഓക്കെ നിങ്ങളുടെ മോട്ടോർ മാത്രമാണ് വണ്ടി ഓടിക്കുന്നത്. ഓക്കെ എഞ്ചിൻ വണ്ടിയുടെ വീലായിട്ട് കണക്ട് ചെയ്തിട്ടില്ല. അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ നിങ്ങളുടെ ബാറ്ററിയോ മോട്ടറോ അടിച്ചു പോയി കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ വണ്ടി വഴിയിൽ തന്നെ കിടക്കും. സോ വാട്സ് എ പാരലൽ ഹൈബ്രിഡ്? ജസ്റ്റ് എക്സ്പ്ലെയിൻ ഇറ്റ്. ബട്ട് വാട്സ് എ പാരലൽ ഹൈബ്രിഡ്? ഇറ്റ് ഹാസ് ബോത്ത് എഞ്ചിൻ ആൻഡ് ഇലക്ട്രിക് മോട്ടോർ ഇൻഡിപെൻഡൻ്റ്ലി കണക്റ്റഡ്. ഇൻഡിപെൻഡൻ്റ്ലി, ആസ് യു ക്യാൻ സീ here you have your engine, your generator or your manual transmission. Okay, and it connected to the wheels. Also you have your motor connected to the wheels. So both are connected to the wheels. So what it do is, motor drives the vehicle at lower speeds while engine take over at higher speed. So after a particular speed, your motor will be switched off and the engine will switch on. Engine will be started and engine will drive the vehicle. In the next slide, I will explain the layout of Koenigsegg Regera, which is the hypercar. Okay, so literally this thing can do much, much flexibility. It is highly flexible in nature. Okay, this one is from the Toyota Prius. Okay, so you can place this engine and motor in one place, means in the front or the rear, or you can place the motor at the rear wheels and engine at the front wheels. So this is what we called flexibility. So the engine can be placed in the front wheels, so engine drives the front wheels, and you can place the motor at the rear wheels, so you have all wheel drive capacity. Okay, or you can just place both of them together. Again, the motor can assist the engine if you need a high torque or hard acceleration. So next slide, I will give you the transmissions of drivetrain of Koenigsegg Regera. This is the hypercar. Okay, it's a parallel hybrid. Okay, so literally, this is the arrangement of Koenigsegg Regera. Okay, now there is no transmission here, no gearbox, zero gearbox, no gearbox is there, but a single gear reduction, you have a single gear, ഒരൊറ്റ ഗിയർ മാത്രമുണ്ട്, അത് സെലക്ട് ചെയ്യണ്ടതല്ല, അത് അവിടെ തന്നെ ഉണ്ടാവും ഫുൾ ടൈം. ഒറ്റ ഗിയർ മാത്രമേ ഉണ്ടാവും, അതിന്റെ റേഷ്യോ ആണ് 2.73. 2.73 റേഷ്യോക്ക് ഏക്കി ഗിയർ ദിയ ഹുവാ ഹെ. ഓക്കെ, നൗ യു ഹാവ് ടു ഇലക്ട്രിക് മോട്ടോഴ്സ് കണക്റ്റഡ് ടു ബോത്ത് വീൽസ് ആൻഡ് ദീസ് മോട്ടോഴ്സ് ആക്ച്വലി 234 ഹോഴ്സ് പവർ, വിച്ച് മീൻസ് ഇറ്റ്സ് മോർ ദാൻ ഇറ്റ്സ് thrice the power of my Wagoner, three times the power of my Wagoner. Teen guna powerful hai mere Wagoner se. Ye electric motor, ek electric motor. Okay, so you have two electric motors, both are 180 horsepower. This is the electric motor, 180 horsepower, which is 234 horsepower. This thing, these motors will drive the wheels at and around 30 kilometer per hour. Okay, and this is the battery pack. Okay, now there is another motor, there is a triple motor setup. This is the another motor, it's called crank machine, like it is around 208 horsepower. Okay, Navneet, I will come to you. Okay, it like Raju also, if I have time I will come to all of you, otherwise I will be available on the tomorrow, I will be available on tomorrow YouTube. So here you have this third motor, which is around 200 horsepower again. It is used to start this engine when the speed reaches 30 kilometer. Okay, now this engine is not a simple thing. It's 820 kilowatt, or literally 1000 horsepower. 1000 horsepower und engine. Or electric motor ekadesham ettom koranja ettom parurna electric motor mathram 200 horsepower und. ഡ്രൈവ് ചെയ്യുന്ന രണ്ട് മോട്ടോറുകളാണെങ്കിൽ 234 ഹോഴ്സ് പവർ ആണ്. അഗർ ആപ്കി മോട്ടർ കി ബാത് കറായ തോ 234 ഹോഴ്സ് പവർ കി ദോ മോട്ടർ ആപ്കി ദോ വീലോ കോ റിയർ വീൽസ് കോ ചലാതി ഹൈ ഓർ ഏക് ക്രാങ്കിംഗ് മോട്ടർ ഹൈ, അസിസ്റ്റൻസ് മോട്ടർ ഹൈ, തീസറ മോട്ടർ വോ ദോ സോ എച്ച് പി കാ ഹൈ, അഗർ ആപ്കി എഞ്ചിൻ ഹൈ തോ 1000 ഏക് ഹസാർ ഹോഴ്സ് പവർ കി യേ ഹൈ കോണിക്സഗർ കാർ. ജബ് മേ ബുലാ ദനാ ഹൈപ്പർ കാർ കി ബാത് കറായ തോ യേ ഹൈ ഹൈപ്പർ കാർ കി ബാത് ഹൈ. ഓക്കേ, after 30 kilometer per hour the engine drives the vehicle. Okay, the motor will be switched off, these two motors will be switched off, and the engine will be directly driving this vehicle. You don't have a gearbox, no gearbox. Okay, instead there is something called a torque converter, a specially designed torque converter. This is called a hydraulic coupling, it's a torque converter, and ultimately drives the wheels using this final gear reduction, a single gearbox, single gear ratio. Okay, so at any time if you are going to low speed and the engine need a help, these two motors, these three motors can actually help it. 1 2 3 three motors can actually help it. So you can actually calculate how much horsepower it is now. 200 200 200, so literally 600 horsepower is in the electric motor, and 1,000 horsepower in the engine. So literally 1,600, 1,600 horsepower hai pure ke pura. ये है एक हाइपर कार की बात का, ओके, ये एक पैरेलल हाइब्रिड है, इसलिए इतना हॉर्स पावर निकाल रहे हैं, क्योंकि यहाँ देख सकते हैं इलेक्ट्रिक मोटर बहुत छोटा है इंजन के, इंजन को कंपेयर करें, इंजन इंजन वैसे नोकिया अब निर्णय 200 കൂട്ടാണെങ്കിൽ 600 ഹോഴ്സ് പവറിന്റെ മൂന്ന് മോട്ടോർ വരുന്നുണ്ട്. എഞ്ചിൻ മൊത്തത്തിൽ 1,000 ഹോഴ്സ് പവർ ഉള്ളൂ. ഈ മോട്ടോറുകളുടെ സൈസ് നോക്കിയാൽ മനസ്സിലാവും എഞ്ചിൻ എഞ്ചിനെ കൊണ്ട് പറ്റുന്ന എഞ്ചിന് 1,000 ഹോഴ്സ് പവർ ഉണ്ടാക്കാൻ പറ്റില്ല. ഈ കുഞ്ഞു മൂന്ന് മോട്ടോർ വെച്ചിട്ട് 600 ഹോഴ്സ് പവർ വരെ ഉണ്ടാക്കുന്നുണ്ട്. സോ അഗെയിൻ നെക്സ്റ്റ് വൺ ഈസ് എ സീരീസ് പാരലൽ ഹൈബ്രിഡ്. ദിസ് ഈസ് ആക്ച്വലി സംതിങ് ദാറ്റ് യൂസ്ഡ് ഇൻ ദ റോഡ് കാർസ്. ഓക്കെ, ഇറ്റ് വർക്ക്സ് just like the name suggests, it works in series configuration and also in the parallel configuration. Okay, so highly flexible and efficient. Then one thing that separate a series hybrid and a parallel hybrid is the power split device. You have to remember this. This is this device, power split device. It's a epicyclic gear. Okay, now this is the diagram. So here this device, this portion is called a power split device. This is the difference between series hybrid, parallel hybrid and series parallel hybrid. Okay, so normally what arrangement look like is this, means you have the engine driving a generator, and the generator, behind the generator there will be a motor. So you have two motors connected to the engine and the wheels. Okay, so the engine can charge the battery. So you can see the engine can just run the ISG and charge the battery, and the battery can be used to drive the wheel, or engine can directly couple with the traction motor. You have a clutch or a mechanism that can connect the engine with the motor. Here the difference is engine is assisting the motor, not the other way around. Okay, engine is assisting the motor in driving. Okay, yaha motor ki assistance engine de rahe hai. Like agar parallel hybrid ki baat kar rahe to engine ki assistance motor kar rahe ho, series parallel ki baat kar rahe to motor ki assistance engine de rahe hai. Okay, so mostly motor will be driving the vehicle. Next slide I will give you a video presentation. Okay, video. I will present you with a video here. Okay, so this is a Toyota's operation. Toyota's video. Just look at the video. Okay, Toyota's hybrid system, the second hybrid system. This is a series parallel hybrid. As you can see, you have two motors. One is generator, one is motor, and you have a power split device. Now, when you start the vehicle, okay, when you start the vehicle and going towards movement, it is not the engine, but the electric motor is actually driving the vehicle. You can see the current is coming from the battery and the motor is driving the vehicle. The engine is still not started. Okay, so the battery is driving the vehicle. It's very clear that there is a power control unit. I will explain that what that power control unit in the, say it's similar to an electric vehicle, so I will explain that part in the electric side. Okay, so when you are accelerating, aap accelerate kar rahe ho, yeah, engine ki motor ki help karunga. It will help the electric motor in driving the vehicle. You can see there is a reduction there. So it depends on the engine. Again, if you are taking the hybrids, there are a lot of technologies coming in, variable valve timing, direct injection. This has been the tumble I actually explained in the GDI engines. Okay, so here if you are accelerating, your engine is helping the motor. Okay, not the other way around. Okay, now if you are mild, if you are running at a constant speed, normal cruise kar rahe hai, like if you are just going in a constant speed, your engine will turn off. You don't need the engine, it's just motor. Okay, if you have the in running on low speed, the engine will switch off. If you are not accelerating that much, the engine will recharge the battery. Okay, it will run like a series hybrid. Right now it is running like a pure electric vehicle. Okay, now again, if you are going downhill, ab niche ja rahe ek mountain ke niche ja rahe to ab regenerate karenga ye motor alternator ki tarah kaam karke regenerate karunga. Okay, so तीन चीजें मैंने एक्सप्लेन किया है, माइल्ड, माइक्रो एंड फुल हाइब्रिड. और फुल हाइब्रिड की तीनों सीरीज हाइब्रिड, पैरल हाइब्रिड एंड सीरीज पैरल हाइब्रिड एक्सप्लेन किया है. सो कन्वेंशनल और प्लग इन हाइब्रिड क्या है? सो व्हाट्स अ कन्वेंशनल हाइब्रिड इज योर इंजिन इज द ओनली वे टू चार्ज योर बैटरी, देयर इज नो अदर वे. ओके, योर इंजिन हैज टू बी स्विच्ड ऑन टू चार्ज द बैटरी. There is no provision for charging it with your household socket or a charging station. Your battery pack may be big, but you cannot charge it from outside. You have to switch your engine on. So from your here you can see, this is the normal normal hybrid electric vehicle. There is no plug point like the plug-in hybrid vehicle. There is a plug where you can use this to charge your battery like this. Okay, you can charge your battery using the plug. So the plug-in can actually utilize an external source. You can charge it with a household socket or a charging station. Okay, so you don't have to use, if you are using it in for a short amount of time, you don't have to charge the battery. Okay, so you don't have, like, you can run this thing completely as an electric vehicle. That's the advantage. So in short, in summary, the hybrids are low hybrids and mild hybrids. Hybrids are 48 volts purely drives. Next one, these are full hybrid systems. Okay, it can come up in series, parallel, and series parallel configuration. Okay, now modern full hybrids are any hybrid you take, even if it is series hybrid or parallel hybrid or series parallel hybrid, majority of the full hybrids comes as a plug-in vehicle. Okay, plug-in hybrids, put that in the chat box or you can switch on your mic and ask me. I will explain it right now. अगर आपके कुछ कोई डाउट है, कोई शक है, तो यू कैन आस्क, यू कैन पूछ सकते, आप पूछ सकते हैं चैट बॉक्स पे, आप पूछ सकते हैं और माइक ऑन करके पूछ सकते हैं. इनके अंदर डाउट नहीं है, पूछो क्या चैट बॉक्स से, चो क्या इलेंगे माइक ऑन इधर चो क्या. प्लीज आई एम ओपन टू or doubts again. Nala 11 manikku you have to come. Ningalde endu doubt undu, it doesn't matter whether your language is Malayalam, Hindi or Tamil, whatever it is, I'll just explain whatever I know. Okay, so if you have any doubt, please ask it right now. Endo ikotta koppilla, doesn't matter whether, like, anyway njan endayalum I told you I will come to tomorrow on YouTube, so you can ask me anything right now if you have any doubt. Okay, parallel hybrid, having in parallel hybrid may engine case tech or okay, as I told you, in parallel hybrid, okay, now it's a good question. Here you can see in the parallel hybrid configuration, just switch on the engine. Okay, here, I will take the example here. So you can see the Koenigsegg Regera don't have a transmission. Yeah, koi gearbox bhi nahi hai.
अगर आपकी इंजन ऑन हो जाए तो यहाँ की कपलिंग है, ये हाइड्रोलिक कपलिंग है, ये टॉर्क कन्वर्टर की जैसा काम कर रहे हैं और यहाँ की ड्राइव स्ट्रेट व्हील्स को जाती है। आपकी गाड़ी अब 30 किलोमीटर पे आ चुके हैं क्योंकि एक मोटर ने आपकी गाड़ी को 30 किलोमीटर तक ले जाया है, तो आपकी इंजन को एक गियर बॉक्स की आवश्यकता नहीं है ड्राइव करने के लिए। आपकी इंजन लो एंड से लाइक 2000 आरपीएम से आपकी इंजन आपकी गाड़ी को चला सकती है क्योंकि इंजन मैक्सिमम टॉर्क प्रोड्यूस कर चुका है। ओके, तो स्ट्रेट अवे इंजन कैन ड्राइव द व्हीकल। ओके, दे आर एक्चुअली कनेक्टेड, यू कैन सी हियर। ओके, हियर यू कैन सी द इंजन इज एक्चुअली कनेक्टेड टू द व्हील्स। देयर इज अ हाइड्रोलिक कपलिंग बिकॉज व्हेन यू आर ब्रेकिंग, आप अगर आपको ब्रेक कर रहे हो वो ब्रेकिंग इंजन पर नहीं आ सकते क्योंकि एक हाइड्रोलिक कपलिंग है, एक सेफ्टी मेजर है। ओके, you have safety measure because when you're braking, this force of braking will not come to the engine, so engine is escaped. Okay, so like this. Anyone else? This presentation being the biggest, largest one, this thing has been uploaded in the YouTube. You can go and check. This is the YouTube channel, Learn Auto Tech. You can go and watch the presentation. You can download the presentation. Tomorrow I will be there on Learn Auto Tech. So you can ask me any doubt. Or you can just write me. You can email me. Okay. My email address also been given here. This is my email address. You can write to me. I will answer. So you have any doubt, doesn't matter which, what language you are, I will answer in that language. I don't know any other languages than Hindi, Tamil, Malayalam and English. So don't ask me in Punjabi or Gujarati. I don't know. So you can ask me in English, Hindi or Tamil or Malayalam, whatever it is, you just can ask me. Don't worry. I will answer in that language. Any doubt, doesn't matter whether you have this doubt in the hybrids or you have a doubt in any MPFI, whatever it is, whatever your doubt is, you can please ask. You can put that doubt in the chat box. Put your doubt in the chat box. I will answer it, just like Navneet just done. This is the first time. Yeah, I believe nobody has a doubt. Everyone just understood. And that a good teacher or not? ഇത്ര നല്ല ടീച്ചറാണ്, എല്ലാവർക്കും എല്ലാം മനസ്സിലായോ? സോ ഇഫ് യു ആർ ടേക്കിംഗ് ദ ഹൈബ്രിഡ്സ്, മാരുതി ഈസ് യൂസിംഗ് എ മൈൽഡ് ഹൈബ്രിഡ്, സിയാസ് ഹൈബ്രിഡ്, എർട്ടിക, എവറിതിങ് ഈസ് എ മൈൽഡ് ഹൈബ്രിഡ്. ഓക്കെ, ഇറ്റ് ഹാസ് ദ ISG. Just open the bonnet and you can see the ISG, and there is a lithium ion battery under the co-driver seat or under the passenger seat. Thank you, Kushal. So hybrids are actually like till 2019 March tak tax reduction for hybrid vehicles. Right now it is not there. If you are going to buy a hybrid vehicle, that tax reduction has been taken away. Okay, you don't get a tax reduction if you are buying a hybrid vehicle. In 2019, I believe, 2019 March, they has been you
will get the tax reduction if you are buying an electric. Karanam, which is tax reduction go to the term, Arum, hybrid, Anchila, Adigarun, Dakidula. Hamare Yahaki or World Key both Ache. The best hybrid right now selling in the world is Toyota Prius. Okay, Toyota Prius is the best or the largest sold hybrid in the world. It works as I explained to you in the hybrid system. This is the same. It's a series parallel hybrid. Okay, this is the series parallel hybrid system which again Toyota Prius use. Usko 40 lakh. Price tag hai. Okay, 40 lakhs. That's the price tag. 40 lakhs aanu inde vela. Okay. So hybrid vehicles are costly because you need an engine, you need an electric motor, you need a battery pack. It's heavier too. But mileage, a Toyota Prius will give you 50 km per liter. 50 किलोमीटर पर लीटर दे दूंगा टोयोटा प्रियस अगर आप 40 लाख दे दे तो आपके बेंस की कीमत चुकाने पड़ेगा आपको एक अच्छे हाइब्रिड व्हीकल खरीदना है तो ओके टोयोटा प्रियस इज ऑलवेज अवेलेबल अगेन मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द लेक्सस कार्स आर हाइब्रिड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द लेक्सस कार्स आर हाइब्रिड लेक्सस टोयोटा लक्जरी वर्जन Lexus cars are hybrid. Toyota Camry is hybrid. Okay. All majority of the Toyota's lines are hybrid. Again, if you're taking the Alphard and the Welfare, every Toyota's high-end vehicles are hybrids. They don't have a pure IC engine vehicle. Okay. Except I think the low-end vehicles, Etios, Liva, these kind of vehicle don't have a hybrid. Remaining all the vehicles, majority of the vehicles, they have a hybrid. Lexus only have hybrids, only hybrids. And right now they are pushing the electric vehicles for 2025. Majority of the manufacturers are pushing electric vehicles. So any doubt, please ask. So if you have any other doubt, you can come to YouTube channel tomorrow. You can ask. The link for this will be given in the NIMI Facebook page, NIMI Chennai Facebook page. There will be link provided for this presentation. Okay. The link will be provided in the NIMI Facebook page. You can go to NIMI Facebook page and NIMI Chennai. NIMI Chennai Facebook page, you will find this link for this video, or you can just come to the YouTube channel. You can watch this 1,000 times. Okay, or I will explain your doubt. Agar aapko puchne ke liye nahi aaye the. Okay, so any like. I believe you know they had a doubt. So thank you all. Thank you for coming. Thank you for supporting. But thank you, Nimi, for this on Saturday. So my electric class. Chahe to aajao. YouTube pe zarur milega. Aajaye, nahi aajaye to fir bhi aapko presentation YouTube pe milega. Okay. Thank you for coming, everyone.